Dear students, this time we have the topic to discuss entitled The Unity of All Living Things in context with the novel A Passage to India by E.M. Forster. We have discussed several aspects of this novel and come to know that it is just to explore the possibility of friendship between the subject and the rulers in the British Raj. And we have also come to the conclusion that that time it was not possible to have any friendship between the British and Indians because they were deeply divided on racial grounds. Here we are taking into account the underlying theme of this novel, which has been driven from the religious text of Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, and other religious texts. Yes, it is all the viewpoints which have been expressed in the religious text, how to live and how to deal with the living beings of the society, and at the same time how to make a cohesive progress into biological diversity. Just we find that the characters have been cast from different religious groups, including Muslim. There is a character, Dr. Ajiz, who is Muslim. And at the same time, we find that there are characters from Christian group, and there are characters from Hinduism. And we find that these characters are playing a large thematic role in the novel. So we can see that the author has very intentionally cast these characters to deal with the very much basic preamble of religious text, especially religious text of Hinduism, which is concerned with the ideal of all living things. We find that in this universe there are many kinds of living beings. There are loyalist living beings, they are the highest living beings from their a structural development point of view, from their mental development point of view, from their material development points of view. But ultimately, these are all the external considerations which we people have made. We have analyzed the importance of living beings in terms of the material development, mental development, social and cultural development. These considerations do not have any relation with the religious consideration, because religion does not deal with the progress of human being from the point of view of material development and intellectual development. Rather, the religious preamble is just to explore the possibility of making all living beings survive. It does not have to focus on the other factors, including the factors of economic prosperity and so on. Here the cohesive existence of all the living beings have been first and foremost consideration to me. And so in Hinduism we find excessive emphasis has been laid down on the cohesive progress of all the living beings.
Here, our thought has been extended to the point that we have included even the existence of non-living beings also. We cannot say that we are the supreme being, so we should overrule everything and we should minimize the significance of other living beings. You know, here we find that honor and respect have been paid to each and everything, whether material or immaterial, whether small or big, whether significant and non-significant. We find that our existential possibility is all due to the unified relationship with all the living beings. And in unification of all the living beings, love plays a very dominant role. You know, we find that it is what the mysticism of Hinduism is, which is exploring all the relationship on the basis of a mystic explanation of the existential the survival of the things. So we can say that there are differences, there are individual differences. It is bound to happen. Individually, the living beings are different. They are not the similar. Not in their structure, not in their mentality, not in their thought and so on. It is why the author has taken the character from different groups. Dr. Aziz, Mr. Fielding, Adela, and so on. You find that they are representing different religious groups. So they have differently followed different ideals of religions. Despite the differences in the religious viewpoints, there should be an inherent thread of love to make it possible to have the friendship among them, that they should be unified. When you are talking about the friendship of a Hindu and Christian, or Hindu or Muslims, or Muslims and Christians, we intend to mean that we originally are the same, but externally there is little bit difference, but our existence is all due to collective unification. So we used to be unified. It is why the novel starts from the preamble of finding possibility of friendship among Muslims or Indians and Christians. So it is the matter of recognition of the human value that can make it possible to love each other. And unless we love each other, there is no question of making any kind of friendship among the people. We cannot find that friendship is possible sans love. So it is all mystic search that the author is making in the novel when he is trying to find out the possibility of making friendship between Indians and Christians. He simply is concerned with a thing that there should be a ground for friendship between these different characters. But it is not only in name that we can say that friendship is possibly made. Friendship actually is made when we have recognized each other completely. We have discarded the value of differences, which racial explanation makes. You know, it is all the misinterpretation of human society and human beings which have been made on the basis of racial explanation. Race does not permit us to go to that extent and make this kind of thing. We cannot say that it is possible for us to have a friendship without love. And when we want to have love, we should discard all the differences which are just coming on the floor. So here is the Hindu character, you know, Professor Godbole. We can say that he is the most visible Hindu in the novel. And we can say that Godbole is Foster's mouthpiece for this idea of unity of all living things. Because when you are talking about unity of all living things, we are going to discard the level of conflicts. And we are in search of finding the possible grounds to come together, to stand together. You find that this is the reason that Godbole alone remains aloof from the drama, our main actions of the drama and plot development. He refrains himself from taking sides, because when we are taking sides on any ground, on racial ground, in other ground, we find we cannot make an exploration of possibility of developing friendship, because in that situation you find there is no question of having any friendship without love. So especially we find that in the Abel of Marwar, all the possibilities are going to dawn. The possibilities which were just very much visible between Dr. Aziz and Mr. Fielding, it's going to dog all because of the Abel of Marwar. Here we find that there is a mistaken idea, and that mistaken idea has rooted out all the possibilities of developing friendship among the characters. So, this is so deep, you know, we find that racially the society was so deeply divided that we have developed the mistaken idea to the level of rooting out all the possibility of friendship. Yes, there is no openness to search for the actual proof that the characters could remove mistaken ideas that they have developed into the caves of Marwar. Because when we are overcast with a kind of prejudice, say on the basis of race and something like that, we are losing openness of thought. We are losing the possibility of coming of purity of thought to our brain. And Hinduism is just giving us a chance to explore the truth. And to explore the truth, we should be pure at our thought, at our mind, that we can see everything in actuality. Mrs. Moore here shows openness to this aspect of Hinduism. We can say that she is following the concept of unity of all living things, because she has not been the part of British administration, that she was not bound to rule India on any false ground. So she has come here just to search for the reality of the society as Indian society was that time. And so she is just very much unhappy with the development of the behavior pattern at the party that Westerners are developing to Indians. She does not like all the rude and inhuman behaviors that Westerners are showing in the party for the Indians. She takes ill of everything because it is just inhuman
It is just on the false pride that Westerners have developed for themselves, that they are more superior racially speaking, and the black is less superior racially speaking. And when this kind of notion is prevalent, there is no chance of making any kind of friendship among the people. So, Mrs. Moore appeals to feel a great sense of connection with all living creatures, as Hinduism is propagating. And we find that she also has respect for the wasp in her bedroom. It is what? The minute detailed description of love and a spread of love is there in the text of Hinduism. So Hinduism goes to the extent where we are just going to respect even the inanimate thing like a stone, and we think that this stone is no longer a stone, rather we have found life into the stone, rather it is the super life that is always into the stone, and we start worshipping it. So that stone, which was just separated, has become just linked with our life, and through that stone we have linked ourselves mystically with all the religious existence. So Mrs. Moore is just not falling into a kind of illusion that is created by the false and mistaken idea of the Westerners in the novel, because she shows that the vision of oneness of all living things can be realized when we are just shaking off all our false prides in the name of race and everything. And Hinduism is not propagating the idea of any sort of just a superiority, inferiority. It is just to extinct our personality. It is just to extinct our individual superior visions for anything else. And when we extinct our conceit, our pride, we are readily available to make us mingle with everything. So we become watery in that way. We do not remain astonished just when we are extincting our prejudice and so on. And at that time, we shake hand with all the living and non-living things, and we recognize them, and the idea of making oneness of many things is just possible to realize. So it is here that it is the implied or what you can conclusion that you find. And Mrs. Moore and Godbole just are simply not to add anything out of their own thinking that they had on the basis of their race and on the basis of their education and on the basis of other facts. Really, they are accepting what reality is. That reality is that society was divided, and when society was divided, how can you just make an exploration for friendship? It is not possible, because in loveless society, we cannot make any kind of possibility of finding certain kind of unification among the human beings living together. We find that they all are living together. One is subject, another is ruler. However, they do not come closer. Physically, they are working at the same place. It is another thing, but mentally, emotionally, they are not connected. And hence, we find that they remained just at certain distance. So we find that it is the lack of distinction that in Dorr's age, Hindu idea of oneness of all living things. So the author suggests that there may be inherent problems with it. There may be certain different just viewpoints within it, but ultimately we just find certain kind of unification. As you find in music that all sounds are different from one another, but when they are played, they are unified in the way that music is created. Now we do not realize all different sounds individually. We realize that each and every sound is going to contribute to the formation of music. Similarly, the situation of the society and the people and all the living things, that they are singing their own songs, but they are singing in the way that a universal music is coming out from it. And all the individual sounds that they are making are lost, and we only hear and hear one music out of it. So we find that this is here the idea of coherence, which is going to make a basis for the idea of unity of all living things. And so in Indian society, you find politically speaking there was muddle of administration, muddle of behavior pattern, and you find that this model has been very, very distinctly dealt with in a passage to India. And it was all due to the model that the ruler was able to rule the country, because they remained ruler. They have not been actual ruler to just make welfare for their subject. You know, it was just a kind of separation which always remained present among the subject and the ruler. It was simply a dangerous and disorientation of disorder which were intentionally created. And it was not any kind of mystery. No, we cannot say that it was a mystery. It was an intentional disorientation in the society to create a muddle among the people that the ruler can easily rule. So here the sense of religiosity is gone. Religiosity is not just going to make someone ruler and another subject. It is all administrative setup which is run on certain what you can call principle and something like that. But here the principle of love is just very much instrumental to deal with the mystical relationship among all the things which are present in the universe and our connectedness with all these things. So we have admitted in the novel that India is a model. And although we can find that there are some figures such as Mrs. Moore and Gord Bowley who are not thinking that there should be muddle in the political system. They are ideational. They try to make an ideal situation that let muddle be changed by mysticism, where love should come forward to make India combine together and move together. So we find that in all landscape, in the architecture, we can find that in natural life, in animals, there are certain kind of differences. But because of the fact that they have their identification, personal identification, we can never say that in nature two things are one, because it is just the personal identification which makes two things two. But when we find that there is a question of living together, they get unified. And because they get unified, We give a space to each to prosper, to flourish, without making any kind of problem of their existence. We give chance to all of them to flourish. And when the ruler is giving chance all the subject to flourish, there should be the possibility of friendship to emerge. But when we think that it is only our existence which is important, and we are making our existence possible on the cost of the existence of the ruled, we are just creating disorientation of order. We are making a chaotic society, and there is no mystic love to unify us. And we find that we are just going to exploit everything. So is done by Ronnie, that the model is created by Adela in the beginning by some mystical idea, but Ronnie and other Western white color people are always engaged to fan that model, to the extent that there should be a very harsh and deep line of division among the people. But ultimately they are not success, all because of the fielding approach, all because of Mrs. Moore's approach. And Adela herself realizes her mistaken idea. And so there is just another line of division among the Christians, because Christians are once again divided, some in favor of the truth, another in favor of the racial prejudice. So we can say that there was no chance of making any kind of possibility of prosperity of each and everything. When we consider the prosperity of each and everything, we find we give chance to develop the coherence and system of cohesiveness, where each is allowed to develop its own existence without hampering the existence of other. So it is what we can say, and thank you for listening all this.